Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I want to do a brief review about adding and subtracting whole numbers. And if this is something that you're struggling with, please talk to your instructor. Maybe a different class would be a better fit for you. When you add numbers, you want to make sure that you line them up one on top of the other according to their place value, and then just add straight down. So 3 plus 1 is 4, 5 plus 2 is 7, 2 plus 1 is 3, and then there's nothing under the ones. I just bring that down, and then I put a comma between the periods as we saw before. But sometimes when you add numbers, you might have to carry a value because you can only put one number in each place value. So here I have 9 plus 1, which is 10. I put the 0 and I carry the 1. 3 plus 2 is 5 plus 1 is 6. 7 plus 5 is 12. Put the 2, carry the 1. 6 plus 5 is 11, plus 1 is 12, carry the 1, and then 9 plus 1 is 10, and again I'm going to put a comma between the periods, 102,260. If I'm asked to find the sum, as you learned in a previous video, the sum means you're going to add. So 45,000 looks like 45 and then 3 zeros. We have 45 in the thousands period and none in the ones period. And that separates our numbers, and 20, well, 20 just would go here. So we have to make sure that we line up those numbers according to their place value. Then I would just add those together, and I don't have anything to carry here. I'm just adding straight down. Okay, let's look at subtraction. When you subtract a number, again, you want to line things up according to their place value, but now we're subtracting or taking away the value on the bottom, which is the subtrahend from the value on the top. The number on the top is the minuend. 8 minus 0 is 8. 6 minus 2 is 4. 7 minus 5 is 2. Now I have 3 minus 9. I can't do that, so we borrow from the number to the left. I'm going to borrow and leave 1 behind, and I'm going to bring 1 here. So now I can say 13 minus 9, which is 4. And then I'm going to bring that value down. And then I put the comma between the periods, 14,248. So I borrow when I have to. If I have to borrow for more than one place, do you see how I need to borrow all three of these in the ones, the tens, and the hundreds? I'm going to make 2,000 into 1,990, and then I'm going to make this a 10 over here. That's how I'm going to carry that problem out. So really I have 1,990, and instead of 99 in the ones, I'm going to make that a 10. Then 10 minus 7 is 3, 9 minus 5 is 4, 9 minus 4 is 5. Again, I can't take 3 away from 1, so I'm going to borrow from the 5, make that 4. I'm going to bring the 1 up here, and now I have 3 from 11, which is going to be 8, and I'm going to bring that 4 down and get 48,543. So you just have to practice that. The 9s go all the way to the very last place, and then you put the 10. So I have a couple more for you to practice that, because that's the one that I guess is, I would think, is the most difficult. Here it says find the difference of 12,000 and 1,711. Well, first I want to know what we're doing. We're subtracting because it's difference. And the and separates the two values. So I have 12,000, which is this, and 1,711. That's what that looks like. So now I'm going to borrow again from that 2. I'm going to make that 1. I could have put that down a little bit. Everything becomes 9 except the last value becomes 10. 10 minus 1 is 9. 9 minus 1 is 8. 9 minus 7 is 2. 1 minus 1 is 0. And then I have 1. That gives me 10,289. Two word problems examples. One, the two tallest mountains in the United States are Mount McKinley at 20,320 feet and Mount Whitney at 14,494 feet. What is the sum of their heights? What we're asking you to do here is to add, because that's the sum. 20,320 plus 14,494. adding straight down. Notice I'm always writing those, lining up the place values. I have 4. 9 plus 2 is 11. 3 plus 4 is 7. Plus 1 is 8. 4. And 2 plus 1 is 3. So what I get for their total height is 34,814 feet. And finally, I want to show you another problem that could come from a chart, because sometimes you're not always given numbers directly. In this last problem, it says, what is the difference in the number of students from China and those from Taiwan? And then they give us a graph to show that. These are the number of international students in the U.S. by country of origin for 2015-16. Well, we have China here, and the other one was Taiwan, which is here. So those are the two different rows that we're looking at. And I know this chart is a little bit difficult to read, but this says 328,547. So that's the value of the number of students from China. And then we're going to find the difference. So that's a subtraction problem. So we're subtracting the number of students that were from Taiwan, which is 21,127. So then we're going to subtract. 7 minus 7 is 0. 4 minus 2 is 2. 5 minus 1 is 4, 8 minus 1 is 7, 2 minus 2 is 0, and 3 minus nothing is 307,420. That's the difference between the students from China and those from Taiwan. Thanks and have a